D.B. Cooper.
D.B. Cooper.
D.B. Cooper.
D.B. Cooper.
Walking to an airport back then was like walking into a supermarket.
Put down 20 bucks and you got a flight. That was pretty much it.
That is what Cooper did that day.
The hijacker, carrying a briefcase which held explosives.
He asks for $200,000 and 4 parachutes. Once his demands have been met,
jumps out of a damn jet in the middle of the night. I mean, there's just something kind of badass about that.
When he got on a plane last night, he was just another passenger, but today, master criminal.
He was a kind of a god.
I think he's one of the slickest cats that ever walked on the face of the earth.
He is this anti-hero, individualist figure.
We don't know who he is or was, where he came from, or where he went.
This is a case that questions who you are, what you believe, what you want to believe, and what really happened.
Anybody with a laptop can feel like they're investigating.
The best work in the case has been done recently by citizen sleuths.
My team has no doubt we have found D.B. Cooper. You won't believe how crazy it gets.
Every piece of this story is controversial. Every fact is not quite the fact that you think that it is.
This case is one of the most interesting things that I participated in the FBI. It endures.
There are new suspects all the time, but there's no direct link to any of them.
Focus on the facts.
This case forces you to question your own sanity.
Why did you run, Bob, if you're not guilty?
We have over 100 pieces of evidence.
The treasure's too great. It's too good a story.
Cooper's f***ing dead.
I know who he is in my heart.
You're sucked into the Cooper vortex.